Welcome to part one of this video series on creating columns in SharePoint 2013. Here, we'll demonstrate how to create and use these columns: single line of text, choice, currency, multiple lines of text, and hyperlink or picture. Because column options are nearly identical for lists and libraries, I'll use a list, but we'll note any differences for libraries. As a starting point, we have a default custom list named Outer Banks Ferry Information with one column named Title. We'll rename that column and create four additional columns to contain route information. Let's change the column name to reflect that it will contain ferry names. Click the List tab and List Settings. Under the Columns section, click Title to open the column for editing. Change the title to Name. We want this column to remain a single line of text. Let's add a description. We want to require that a name be entered, so that field remains checked for Yes. Each name will be unique, so that field should be Yes as well. Lower the maximum number of characters in the name to 20. Since we're requiring unique values, there's no reason to enter a default value. We're ready to save the column, so click OK. Indexing is required for unique values, so click OK again. You'll see that the column name has changed to Name. Now, let's create the next four columns dealing with information for the public. First, create a column for Ferry class. We're still on the Settings page, so click Create Column and enter its name. Since there are three ferry classes, let's use Choice as the type of information. This lets the user select the class from a predefined list of three. Add a description and make the information required. We should not enforce unique values because several ferries may be in the same class. Enter Hatteras, River, and Sound as the classes. Because there are only three choices, let's choose radio buttons for the display. If you have four or more choices, it's generally better to use the drop-down menu because it's more compact. Avoid using checkboxes unless you really need to allow more than one choice. Multiple selections can interfere with other SharePoint features, such as sorting and filtering. It's also a good idea to avoid using fill-in choices. If users are allowed to enter the ferry class, it's quite likely you will get inconsistent data and typos. Plus, any choices that are entered manually are not added to the selection list, so they are not automatically available to others. Most of the ferries belong to the Hatteras class, so we'll leave Hatteras as the default. Be sure the column is added to the default view of all items, then click OK. Here's the column we just created. The next column is Fare. Click Create Column. Name the column Fare and choose the type of information to be currency. Enter the description. We want data to be required, but not unique. The fare can range from free, which is $0, to $10. Two decimal places are standard, and we want to leave the default value blank and the format as U.S. currency. Ensure the column is in the default view, then click OK. The next column is Route. Click Create Column. The column name is Route and type of information is multiple lines of text. Here's the description. We'll require that the column contains data. The number of lines for editing is the number of lines in the text box where users enter the route. This setting controls the size of the text box, not the amount of text that's entered. The default is 6, but let's change it to 4 because the route information is usually concise. The text can be plain text or enhanced rich text, which includes formatting, hyperlinks, images, and tables. We'll opt for plain text. Here's one gotcha. When you create a column as we are doing here, you have two options: plain and enhanced rich text. But when you edit an existing column, you'll see a third option for rich text. If versioning is on, checking Yes here adds the new content to the previous content instead of replacing the previous content. We'll skip that option. There are a couple of differences if you use the multiple lines of text column in a document library. First, there is a limit of 255 characters unless you select the option to allow unlimited length. But use this setting carefully. Office applications only support columns with up to 255 characters, so you may lose data. Second, these two options, type of text and append, are not available in document libraries. Let's complete our column. We want it in the default view, so click OK. The next column is Photo. Click Create Column. Enter photo as the name and select hyperlink or picture as the type of information. Enter a description. We are not requiring content, but we do want to format the column as a picture, not a hyperlink. Be sure the column is added to the default view, then click OK. Let's return to the list and see what we've done so far. Here are the column types for single line of text, choice, currency, multiple lines of text, and hyperlink or photo. Now, let's add a new item to see our column settings at work. Before we do that, let's go to the Images library to get the address for a fairy photo we've already uploaded. Click Images, hover over the fairy picture, and click the ellipsis. Use Ctrl-C to copy the URL. Go back to the list and click New Item. Note where the descriptions appear. We wrote them so they could serve as prompts to help the user with data entry. Let's enter a name of Hatteras, select a class of sound, and enter a fare of 15. Use Ctrl-V to paste the web address of the photo and enter Hatteras for the photo description. Click Save. We set up some tests when we created these columns, and it looks like our data failed those tests. Route is required, so let's enter a route description and try to save the item again. The fare of $15 exceeds the maximum value of $10. The fare should actually be $5, so let's correct the typo. Click Save, and this time we're successful. Note that the route column cannot be sorted or filtered because it contains multiple lines of text. In this video, we've reviewed how to create columns for a single line of text, choice, currency, multiple lines of text, and hyperlink or photo. Parts 2 and 3 of this video series review creation of other column types, and there are additional videos on site columns and on editing and validating columns. Two columns are reserved for use by web services: external data and managed metadata. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main Help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the Help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.